of the Toulouse Goose. It's by Dr. Jael Zebulun.
Once upon this time, there is a wonderful farm called North Bradbury Farm, which is home to many animals, and this film always with the sounds of children laughing. Because farmer Grace and Tracy kept it so the holiday cottages for families to come and visit. Among the many animals of North Bradbury Farm, there are, of course, also geese who contribute their fair share of eggs, which the farmer always gives their friend, Dr. Z, for baking her famous chocolate goose egg cake. The geese also help keep the grass cut. Geese are known as lawnmower birds and turn the grass nicely without eating all of it. They snap it off in the middle like a lawnmower. Sometimes geese can also provide downy feathers, which are very fluffy feathers under the wings remaining soft pillows, which feathers fall off or gently brushed off the moat. When geese shed their feathers and grow new ones. Beyond that, geese help defend the farm against intruders by making a loud HONK sound when anyone, whether an animal or a person, is coming. The grass farmers and police know they have a visitor. They can go greet the visitor if it's a friend, or chase the visitor away if it's a fox trying to steal one of the chickens, for example. Griselda the Toulouse Goose was one of these geese, the forerunner and first chosen of all the geese and goose dumb on North Bradbury Farm during her time. It is right that she was the first pig, since the Toulouse Gray is a very old type of goose, going as far back as 1555. They were first brought to the United Kingdom by Lord Derby, the Earl of Derby, around 1840. Farmers Chris and Tracy knew Griselda was a fine start for the new generation of geese on North Bradbury Farm, so they went ahead and bought her a friend to keep her company always, Genghis the Gander. Gander is what you call a goose that's male, was an Emden goose. Then, for good measure, they also bought two more Emden geese, Bianca Blanca and Candy Blanca. And all the Emdens thought Bianca Blanca was the prettiest goose who had ever lived on the earth. Sadly, that included Genghis the Gander, who was supposed to be Griselda's faithful friend and keep her company. But he never really got to know Griselda very well, because he spent all his time with Bianca Blanca and Candy Blanca. He walked with them, talked with them, and even ate with them. Griselda was always nearby but felt invisible because nobody paid attention to her. The other kids weren't mean to Griselda and they didn't push her around, but they never spoke to her. They never said, "Good morning, Griselda," or "How are you, Griselda?" And they never invited her to go swimming with them. They never made conversation with her. Never said, "Wow, I sure hope it rains today. Do you think it will?" Or, "You look really nice today." Or anything at all. They only spoke to each other, not to her. In short, they were very rude. Now, Candy Blanca was sweet and peaceable. He wasn't being rude on purpose. Naturally, he didn't mind if Genghis wanted to be friends with Bianca or himself. That was also good with him, and he liked Genghis very much as a friend.
only they never invited Griselda the Toulouse Goose to visit. They didn't even talk to her. She felt all alone. This hurt her feelings and she began to wonder. Is it because I am Toulousean and not from Emden like Genghis, Gandhi and Bianca? Did Issy say something to hurt their feelings? Why don't they ever speak to me? But Griselda the Toulouse Goose just kept doing everything she was supposed to do, getting elves, shedding her town, mowing the lawn, and helping call the farm. She was doing her part. Still, the time came that Bianca made a whole crush of eggs. Griselda had never laid but just one egg at a time. And they were always taken away by the farmers to give their friend Dr. Daisy for baking delicious yummy goose egg quiche. Griselda wanted to be happy for Bianca, but she felt ashamed instead. Meanwhile, Bianca Blanca looked so happy with her elves and her friends telling her how proud they were of her. Hence, Griselda the Goose from Toulouse finally waddled off towards the forest, feeling like her heart would break but not wanting anyone to see her cry. As she made her way toward the trees, she heard a goose with a Canadian accent say, "Bonjour, ma chérie. What a beautiful color of silvery gray you are." She was so surprised. She looked all around to see who the voice could possibly be talking to, but she didn't see anyone besides herself. So she looked straight ahead, trying to see the source of the voice. A sleek black head with white mask beneath the chin popped out of the bushes. "You had better come with me. We wild geese don't want to get mistaken for the tame ones. Ha 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 ha." He was laughing. She had never heard the Emden geese laugh, only honk and chatter. She had seen them smile but never laugh. She wanted to laugh too. Griselda the Toulouse Goose looked behind her over her shoulder at the farm, but then she looked at the sweet dog-eyed face in front of her. She decided to try life as a wild goose. So she waddled into the bushes and followed the dog-eyed goose to the nearest clearing. He said, "My name is Charles the Canadian. I am so happy to meet you." She said, "My name is Griselda the Toulousean, and I am happy to meet you too." She was really happy and started laughing. Charles said, "We had better get going before someone tries to turn us into tame geese, eh?" Tame geese live on a farm, but wild geese live free wherever they can find a home. Griselda said, "I am ready to go." And it was true. Even as she spoke the words, she realized that she had been ready to go before she even met Charles. Then they started flapping their large goose wings. They began to lift off the ground. After that, they started to really fly. Charles flying out front. When Canadian geese fly, they fly in a V shape. The strongest flyers fly all front, like Charles was doing. Then, once behind them, a fly a little above them through the wind, coming from the flapping wings in front under the wings of the ones behind them. It's called upwash and they don't have to flap as hard. The ones in the front do the hard work and it's easier on the ones in back. If the ones out front get tired, they will fall behind a while so they can rest. Charles has very strong wings and was an expert flyer. Thus, they flew, until they saw a pond in the forest down below. It had a cascade on one end, which is to say a small waterfall, and a creek on the other. They had landed on the water. When Griselda looked at the bank alongside the pond, she saw 50 fluffy baby geese. Baby geese are called goslings, and also 5 young geese who were gray with pale yellow and white heads. Griselda thought they all looked like the goose she had followed through this place. The babies were tiny, and the young geese were just starting to get the beginning of gray feathers called pin feathers. She wanted to cuddle those baby goslings, so she swam to the bank and climbed up, Charles following her. Mother Goose, they cried as they ran up to her, the little fluffy one snuggling under her wings. That's right, at last I have found a mother in you, said Charles, the Canadian goose. Griselda was happy and she started laughing again. Charles laughed too, but the wee bitty babies were too little to laugh, so they just snuggled up next to her. It was the happiest Griselda had ever been. She thought for just a moment about the 3 and then geese back on North Bradbury Farm, and she wished them well. She thought about Bianca Blanca's clutch of eggs and 7 to 10 baby goslings, and she wished them well. But she began to think it was a very good thing for her that Genghis Begander, Bianca Blanca, and Gandhi Blanca hadn't paid her very much attention. If they had, who would be the mother of all these wild geese? They needed a mother, and it so happened Griselda needed them too. Now she was the mother of 100 and would never be lonely again. She could never been so happy as a tame goose as she was for now, for in fact she had the heart of a wild goose. And now it seemed everything had happened to her was very good, for it had made her go toward the forest and toward Charles. Her future had rewritten the past. Naturally, in about a year, Griselda laid her own clutch of eggs, which hatched and turned into fluffy little goslings, her very own babies. Some would grow up to be silvery gray like her mother, Griselda the Toulouse goose, while others would have silky black heads with white napkins under their chins and gray feathers with black legs like their dad Charles. They would be stunning, beautiful, wild, and free. Their lives would be filled with laughter and joy, and they would all continue to live happily ever after. The past can never rewrite the future, but the future often rewrites the past. The end. And that was Griselda the Toulouse Goose. We thank Dr. Jael Zebulun for letting us use her story. I'm Norah, and remember,